Welcome to GBALL VISION, everyone. I hope you are having a phenomenal day today. Sit back, relax. We got 10 knives from 2023 that are all extremely, extremely good knives. And I'm talking the best of 2023 so far. And we're going to kick it off with the Vosteed knives, previously known as the Mayhem, now known as the RS Chaos, I guess is what they're going with for now. This thing, guys, and I would say this is maybe the surprise knife of the year. I don't think anyone expected Vosteed to do something like this and execute it to perfection. M390 on this version. They do have some LMAX versions coming, and I'm guessing they're going to be doing some other variations as well. He did two different blades, Warncliffe and Sheep's Foot. He did a couple different variations, and there's exclusives coming. Like I said, you have a nice cutout and rear flipper tab for all your deployment options. And because this is a compression lock, lefties are going to have, you know, an easy, easy time also deploying this knife because there's no frame lock, bolster lock, anything to get in your way. The rear flipper tab is excellent. The cutout is excellent. Nice little splash of color there with the copper pivot collar. Tons of different milling. You have a nice 3D milled titanium pocket clip. And good job, A+. Full length backspacer, making this thing extremely comfortable. I will be, without a doubt, getting the White Mountain Knives version. And I believe this is the first knife, the first design besides a Spyderco to support or sport the compression lock. And guys, they nailed it. This is probably better than my Smock. I love my M4 Smock, but this might be, as far as the action and the design, this might be better than the Smock. I still have some thinking to do on that, but it is definitely up there with the Smock, if not better. Let's get to the next one. Next up, we got the Quiet Carry 9, and this thing, guys, is a banger. They should have named it the 10, because it is. This thing came out earlier this year. I wish it was in Van-X. It's in 20 CV, which is just fine. Drop point blade, dual thumb studs, incredible action. Great access to the lock bar with a nice big chamfer. Excellent job. Micro milling on the clip side. Relief cut there. Some nice micro milling there. A perfect deep carry titanium pocket clip. Nice little backspacer there. Wish it was a little longer, but that's all right. Ergos are great. This thing is phenomenal. I hope they do one in Van-X. That would be even better. But the Quiet Carry 9 is definitely awesome. Next up, we have the Brass Brigade Grant Tripper. This is the latest model from Brass Brigade. And I gotta say, even though it is a little smaller than I prefer, this thing is executed perfectly. It's done perfectly for, if you had smaller hands, this is the one to go to if you like a little smaller of a knife, your hand's a little smaller. Having a bigger hand, I can still fit on this thing. I just wish it was a little bigger, and I hope he does do a little bit bigger of a version. You have a Tanto blade here, and I think, I want to say he did S35 on this. Maybe he didn't. I'll have to double check on the steel, because I want to say he wanted to go get it out cheaper, but maybe he still went with M390. Regardless, you have a beautiful Tanto blade here, exceptionally well done, jimping on the spine, this awesome cross-cut textured pattern in the titanium, open construction, it is a frame lock, you have a nice milled titanium clip, awesome coffin style cutout for the thumb and reverse flick. The action is phenomenal on this thing. The detent is tuned perfectly on this thing. Perfectly. And it's rare that you can say that about a knife, but this thing is absolutely perfect. The ergos are good. The opening methods all work very good. And my only nitpick is I wish it was just a little bit beefier and a little bit longer. That would be a king right there. That would be a home run, a grand slam. Make this a little bigger, and I am all over this thing. But as it stands, I can see keeping this knife and it being excellent for you, especially as a secondary or a fifth pocket knife. This thing is phenomenal. Let's get to the next one. Next up, we have the Best Tech Sin, and this thing has really surprised me. My first nitpick is I wish this just would have went straight down to the drop instead of having this very last little hump here, because then you would just have a whoop and a whoop. Yeah, it would be a little longer than this one, but that really wouldn't have bothered me at all. I think I would prefer this extra little bit lengthier of a loop to here than this extra ramp. But you know, it works good, especially in all the different grips that you could do with this thing, but I think you could still seriously do without that. But if their reasoning behind this was for the ergos and not the aesthetic, I can really get behind that. This guy is coming in L-Max, beautiful sheep's foot blade with a straight edge. Love that. It's rare that you get that, and I absolutely love it. You have a rectangular cutout for the thumb and reverse flick. This is a bolster lock. It looks beautiful. It's well done, exceptionally well done. Micarta inlays are excellent. Great transitions. The titanium backspacer is awesome. Wish it came up a little bit further, but that's, you know, that's just nitpicking. Nice milled clip that is not reversible. Lanyard hole here. The weight's good. The ergos are good. You got a nice amount of edge here that you'll be able to do a lot of cutting. They got a good design here. It's comfortable as all hell. And I like this thing. I probably see one of these in my future for sure. The Best Tech Sin is definitely a banger. Let's get to the next one. Next up, we got the Wee Knives Xiphius, and guys, this thing is a banger. 20 CV, you have a PVD-coated hollow ground blade here with a satin flat here. Warncliffe style, nice ramp with jimping here. You have dual thumb studs and a flipper tab for the deployment. This has great acoustics. Action is great. The edge came nice. It's slicey. The ergos are good, full finger choil, very comfortable. The action on the button lock is very good. Now, this is very expensive also. You have a flamed anode here with a flamed anode tie clip there. This thing is very nice, guys. But like I said, very expensive. And I don't know that these are even obtainable right now. I could be wrong, but the Xiphius is definitely a phenomenal button lock. One of the best that I've ever handled. There's a couple that are ahead of it, and one of them is on this list, actually. But that doesn't take anything away from this. It's an exceptional, exceptional looking knife, and it is an exceptional knife. This thing is an EDC monster. And it's absolutely excellent. Love the look of this thing. Love the ergos. It's great. Let's get to the next one. Next up, we got the EMP EDC Magnacut Relative, the Bowie edition. You have a beautiful Bowie style Tanto blade here in Magnacut. Full line of jimping across the spine that is just excellent. Full finger choil here. Look at the grind. It's just beautiful. Nice fuller and hole cutout here, along with an excellent designed front flipper. excellent. Works so good. Nice hardware here. It's all like gold anode, titanium. It has extensive milling done on these coated titanium handles. It's one of the most beautiful knives of the year, in my opinion. And then we have the Mokume pocket clip, which just looks exceptional. It really ties this knife together. Looks incredible. And this is number 002, if you didn't know, of the Magna Cut run, which there was only one run. And it makes this a very special knife to me. Let's get to the next one. So the next one isn't necessarily a new design, right? But it's a design with a new mechanism in it. And this is the Chavez 229 Redencion Tanto Kickstop, one of the longest names in history, Ultramar, you know, the Chavez, the 229, the big boy with the Tanto blade. You have the kickstop from Lee Williams there, as you can see on the clip side. And that is a flipper mechanism where the flipper tab hides within the spine of the blade, does not come through. It's an exceptional flipper design. You have thick slabs of titanium. This thing is very, very comfortable. Even though it doesn't have a full-length backspacer, it has a quarter-tie backspacer, the skull pocket clip. Because of the thicker scales, it makes this thing very, very comfortable. I would prefer a longer backspacer, of course, but it's very comfortable. Great access with a chamfer. I love the kickstop mechanism, and I love Chavez knives, so it was a great collaboration and combo between the two. Definitely an exceptional knife of 2023. Let's get to the next one. Next one up is the Wii Exiton. Now, this is top two best button locks of the year from Wii Knives. You're getting 20 CV on that drop point blade. Nice cutout and flipper tab for deployment. You have a titanium handle with carbon fiber as an inlay, like an integral inlay, titanium backspacer. The button lock action is exceptional, and acoustics are very, very good. Ergos are great. Nice drop point blade. Very standard drop point blade, but it just works so well in this design. Wii has done a couple of good things this year, and this is one of them. Typically, I'm not a big fan of Wii knives. They do good stuff, but usually just not interesting enough for me to snag. And I overlooked this and the Xiphias. Missed out on both of them. I wish I would have picked up this Exiton here, but that's all right. Maybe one day I will snag one. But the Exiton, if you have a chance to get one of these, it is an exceptional knife and one of the best button locks that exists currently right now as of 2023. This is one of the best button locks ever. It's definitely up there. Let's get to the next one. Next up is going to be the EMP EDC Ronin. This is actually a one-off, so nobody has this knife, which is better than a 001. You have a satin L-Max Tanto blade with a beautiful satin finish. You have a hand satin on the flats, a nice machine satin there on the hollow grind and the secondary grind here. John's typical opening hole and a phenomenal design on the front flipper. It works very, very good. Full finger choil here, jimping up the spine of the blade. Very, very ergonomic. Beautiful micro milling done on this tie handle as well. gold accents, best tech OEM, little backspacer back here. Here again, I wish we would have a little longer of a backspacer, but the way this is designed, it's very comfortable and does not bother me one bit. The spine doesn't bother me at all. And this thing, I've used this quite a bit, taking care of it, but still using it. It is very well designed, very sharp, very slicey, and very useful due to those two points and two blades. Makes this thing ultra, ultra useful. I love it. It's unique. And I'm a huge fan of the Ronin. This guy has a gold Zerkutai clip. Looks phenomenal. It's got blues and whites and gold in it. Looks very, very good. Let's get to the next one. This may be one of the best knives of the year, and it could have been the best knife of the year had the blade steel have been like Magnica or S90V or LMAX or something. Now, to some people, that won't matter, but to me, it does. And had the backspacer come up a little bit more, this thing would have been definitely in the running for my knife of the year in this price point. You're getting, so it's the Sparrow Knife Co. Strix version 1 M390. It's like a tumbled stonewashed polished sheep's foot blade with a harpoon. That harpoon gives this an incredible opening and closing action just because of that extra weight out towards the tip. You have an enlarged finger cutout there and a well-done front flipper tab. You have a full titanium clip side with a 3D milled clip, geared titanium backspacer, great access with a nice big chamfer. You have a raindrop carbon fiber style inlay here. Transitions are beautiful on the show side. The action's incredible. The acoustics are very good on this thing. Ergos are great. This thing is ultra, ultra slicey as well. Nice hollow grind done on this bad boy. The Sparrow Knife Co. Strix. The version 2 is coming in MagnaCut, and it's definitely going to be even more refined than this guy is, and this is just excellent. Two small things that I wish it would have, and it would have been a total game changer for me. But as it stands, it's still phenomenal and still up at the top of the list. The Sparrow Knife Co. Strix. That'll do it, guys. Give the video a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below. If you're new here, click the GBALL VISION logo or down below the video, hit the subscribe button. Thank you to all my members. Thank you to all the guys who watch all the videos and give a thumbs up, leave a comment. I love all you guys. I'll throw up two new videos here. You definitely should go check out both of them. Love you guys and catch you on the next one.